Shilajit is that blackish-brownish resin coming from the layers of rock found in several mountain ranges around the world, including the Himalayas, Tibetan, and Altai mountains, and it develops over centuries from the slow decomposition of plants, and you find it as a staple in Ayurvedic medicine, being rich in fulvic acid, humic acid, and caratoneoids. In this video, we will look at its uses in improving testosterone and its potential use cases in hair and muscles. We also look at the dosing, side effects, and some safety concerns with Shilajit that I think is so valuable to know as well. So without further ado, real quick before we get started, hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and let's get started. It's important to note also that the research on the potential health benefits of Shilajit is limited. Much of the research stems from lab and animal studies for these conditions, which I hope can expand down the road with peer-reviewed human studies later on, because it's quite an interesting and fascinating herb that I believe is very undervalued. Starting with its first application on testosterone. In 2015, we find a study with men between the ages of 45 and 55. Half of the participants were given a placebo and half were given a 250 milligram dose of purified Shilajit twice a day. After 90 consecutive days, the study found that participants receiving purified Shilajit had a significantly higher testosterone level compared to the placebo group, which is interesting. Also, not to forget to mention improving fertility, as 28 patients out of 60 who completed the treatment showed significant improvement in spermia by 37.6%, total sperm count by 61.4%, as well as motility, which shows a potential increase in spermatogenic activity, which could be nice seeing more research on this as well. Secondly, for hair, there potentially can be two explanations to this. The first is that it contains fulvic acid, which appears to bond with the toxins and heavy metals that invade and disrupt our hair follicles, which is great because if it can in fact do that, it enables the body to expel the toxins more easily. The second way is if somehow the fulvic acid gives the body's cellular walls more flexibility and mineral absorption, then you'll have an increase in the assimilation of food nutrients, which are integral to hair growth. Because as we all know, our diet influences our hair. And if you wanted to try it out, one way you could actually do this is by mixing a tiny amount of Shilajit powder or resin with a carrier oil like coconut or olive oil to create a Shilajit hair oil. Then you can massage the oil into your scalp and hair for several hours or just leave it on overnight. Thirdly, for muscle growth and recovery, specifically in enhancing skeletal muscle performance and attenuating muscle injury, we have made an evidence that Shilajit promotes skeletal muscle adaptation through upregulation of extracellular matrix related genes that control muscle mechanotransduction properties, elasticity, repair, and regeneration. This is why you often see some bodybuilders and athletes take it as a pre-workout and as a post-workout supplement for this very reason. Also remember, testosterone is a hormone that plays a crucial role in muscle growth and repair, right? So by promoting healthy testosterone levels, Shilajit can theoretically help to support muscle growth and recovery while you sleep as well. Let's talk about dosing for a second, because this part can be very tricky. The only recommended dose I was able to find comes from the study titled Shilajit, a panacea for high altitude problems, which by the way, there are claims that it helps with altitude sickness. The dose for maintenance of optimal health is 300 to 500 milligrams a day. But with that said, here are some important tips that you should know of. You shouldn't consume raw or unprocessed Shilajit. Raw Shilajit may contain heavy metal ions, free radicals, and other contaminants that can really make you sick. The Shilajit you purchase must be purified and ready for use. Secondly, avoid taking it if you have sickle cell anemia, hematochromatosis, which is having too much iron in your blood, or thalassemia. It is also possible to be allergic to it as well, so please discontinue it or speak with your doctor if you experience any dizziness, rashes, or increased heart rate. It also may lower blood pressure too, which if you have active heart disease or trouble with your blood pressure, it may be best to avoid it altogether. And what really sucks is that there's a lot of bad quality Shilajit out there, which is why it's best to go with products that are third-party tested and have a solid safety and quality reputation. Not sponsored by them, but Nootropics Depot 250 milligram purified Shilajit is tested for many things like purity, strength, and Heavy Minerals. I left them down below as my affiliate if you wanted to check them out. Also, I left my favorite resin one down below too by NutroTonic, which is this 60-day sun-dried authentic Himalayan Shilajit. If you wanted to try it out on your hair, you can as well. I'm more curious to actually hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on Shilajit? Let me know in the comments below, and also hit that subscribe button if you found any value in this, and I'll see you on the next one.